Welcome back to my YouTube channel, and if it's your first time here, you are so welcome. So this is the lady behind the camera. I hope you guys are enjoying the video. And I was like, okay, I've been showing a lot of videos around Lomé, and you know, you guys have been seeing a lot around this place, and I was like, what if I threw more light about this country? Like, let me tell you 10 top facts. I know I did 10 top facts about the people, but now I'm doing this one about the country itself. Yeah, so if you want to know a lot about this country, yeah, you just have to keep watching. Thank you so much. So without wasting any much of your time, let's get into it. So moving to our first point, this country is called the Republic of Togo, and it's bordered by the west by Ghana, and the east by Benin, and the north by Burkina Faso. And that's why, like, I've noticed that in this country we have a lot of people from Ghana, from Benin, and from Burkina Faso, because it's like a stone throw. It's like very easy to get to Togo from these countries. Yeah, they are like neighbors. And yeah, if you are in Burkina Faso, or you are in Ghana, or you are in Benin, it's a stone throw to get to Togo. Yeah, it's very easy to get to Togo. So that's the first point. Okay guys, moving to our second point, the official language of Togo is French. And I don't know, they have like other indigenous languages. They have like 40 indigenous tribes or groups, I don't know how they call it, and they have like 39 different languages, I don't know, apart from Ewe. Actually, they speak a lot of Ewe, like it's a general language that everybody understands. But you know, in a country, they have like sub villages that speaks like different languages. Like where I come from, I come from Cameroon, and in Cameroon we have like 250 different languages. But in Togo here, they have like French as the official language. They study in school in French, and they have like Ewe, which is spoken by everybody around the country. And they have like sub villages with different languages that they speak. Yeah, so that's what they speak in Togo. As of the population, it was said in 2017 the population was like 7,599,000, I don't know, people. But right now in 2021, I think it's almost 8 million and more. Yeah, the population is growing, and yeah, it's 8 million, you know, because the country is very small. It's a very small country as compared to other bigger African countries like Nigeria, with about, I don't know, hundreds of millions of people. But here we have like just 8 million. Generally in the world, there are a lot of countries, but Togo is ranked like the number 123 largest country in the world. You guys can see where it is, you guys can see the position is like right down there, meaning it's a very small country. And in Africa, it's one of the smallest as well. It's a very very small country, so it's one of the smallest in Africa. From the population, you can know the total land surface is very small. So this country gets their standard of living from, I don't know, high deposits of phosphate in the country. Like, they are one of the leading producer of phosphate in the world. And yeah, it brings a lot of money in the country. And the country also depends a lot on agriculture for, like, you know, their living standards. And you know, most African countries, they depend on agriculture, not only Togo. So yeah, not only African country, like the world, we all depend on agriculture. So it's not just Togo. So they depend on like large deposits of phosphates and agriculture for their living standards. Moving on to religion, I heard about 29% of the population is like, they are Christians, and 20% Muslims, and the rest are like, you know, they practice like different religions, like, you know, what they inherited from their forefathers. But I don't think that's true, because these people go to church a lot. On Sunday, you need to see how like people are flooding the streets and going to church, and these people going to church are Christians. So for me, I would say about 80% of the population in this country, oh, let me not say 80, because there are a lot of Muslims as well, but I would say about 50 goes to church, because you cannot breathe in this country. Everywhere there is a church, there is a church everywhere. In like in Africa right now, there are churches everywhere, and Togo is not left out. Like, before you wake up in the morning, people are already singing in the churches. Like, you cannot sleep, churches everywhere. So a lot of Togolese people are Christians. Yeah, moving on to food, you know, food is like the foundation of a country. These people depend mostly on corn, cassava, plantains, and their sources of proteins are like fish and meat. But fish is the main source of protein because it's cheaper. Yeah, and they grow a lot of corn, like maize. Maize is like, oh my god, everybody, they have different ways of processing this maize into like fufu, I don't know, banku, I don't know, akpan. They have like different ways of processing it. Actually, I was quite surprised when I came to this country because like they have, just from maize, they can produce different kinds of, you know, and they, from this maize as well, they can produce like drinks which are very, very tasty. Oh my god, so I like that from them. In Cameroon, we use maize to produce just like we call it fufu, but here they are using maize to produce like a lot of things, which is awesome. And they grow a lot of beans as well. There is beans here in Togo which is very cheap as well, so yeah, that's a plus. We cannot talk about food in Togo and we don't talk about yam. Yam in Togo is very cheap because like they grow a lot of yams in this country. In Cameroon, mostly we import this kind of yams. Like we import it from Nigeria and it's very expensive. Like for instance, in Cameroon you can get a single yam for 2,000 francs CFA, but in Togo, the same size you can get it like three of them for 2,000 or even cheaper, even for 1,500, sorry. But in Cameroon, just one is like 2,000. But the reverse as well when it comes to potatoes, because like in this country they don't grow Irish potatoes, and you can get like just five potatoes for 500, but in Cameroon you can get a bowl or a bucket for 500. So the reverse, like, you know, we have things that they don't have and they also have things we don't have. Yeah, okay, let's move to the next point. Talking about the soil in Togo, like, is sandy. Okay, my daughter doesn't want me to film, she's making a lot of noise. Sorry guys if you are getting some noises from her. I'm coming to you soon. Mommy is walking. Oh god, what am I supposed to do? Okay, like the soil here is sandy, and yeah, it's very sandy and it's very fertile as well. They grow like granules, cassavas, and yams, and it does so well on this sandy soil because, you know, when the soil is sandy, it's very easy for water to pass through, and you know, so they have like very fertile sandy soils, which are like, which is a plus for them. Like, have you tried growing granules on sandy soils? It's very, very fertile and it's going to produce a lot. Yeah. Hey people, let's talk transportation. Here in this country, they use a lot of motorcycles for transportation, and the taxis are not like very common as compared to other African countries. I've noticed they use a lot of motorcycles here, and they have this brand which is called Olay, and it's very, very affordable. Olay is very affordable, and as compared to taxis are very expensive. So like, they use motorcycles for transportation. Yeah. To the next point, the main source of energy here is like for cooking, they use like charcoal. They use a lot of charcoal here for cooking. They use firewood, but it's rare as compared to where I come from. We use a lot of firewood, but here they use charcoal a lot. And I would say about 20% of the population or 30 uses gas. So the main source of cooking energy is charcoal. Yeah, they use a lot of charcoal. With this, I think I have come to the end of the video, and I hope you guys enjoyed, or you guys learned something about this beautiful country. And if you would like more videos like this, just leave a comment in the comment section. Yeah, and if you think I said something wrongly, please, you can go ahead and I don't know, correct me in the comment section as well. Thank you guys so much for the massive support. I see you all, I appreciate you all, and yeah, let's keep the channel growing. Thank you guys so much, and guess what, we are almost hitting 3,000 subscribers. Like, I can't believe it, in no time, like, we are at 3,000 subscribers, and yeah, the channel is growing. Thank you guys so much. Like, thank you guys for the love, I really appreciate you all. And until next time, bye.